Hi, I'm Raymond Kowis, and I'm graduating this June from the University of Fraser Valley, and I'm a Bachelor of Arts, a French major, and a business minor. I went to Victoria for University Model Parliament, and what this is, it's an area where young university students can come together and basically have a mock parliament, and that's in the legislature in Victoria, so it's a pretty cool experience. And I got to go with the Conservative Party, and the cool part about that is I got to be a minister because we formed government. So basically we were there for one weekend, I think from a Thursday to a Sunday, and it was really neat because there were so many different opinions and different worldviews and different areas from which they were coming, but when it came down to it, we're all there for the common goal of learning how to get involved in the political world and how we thought we could best make a better Canada. So it was really interesting to get to learn all these different perspectives. It was really enjoyable to get to meet lots of people. I'm a social person, so it was enjoyable with that as well. And with regards to the portfolio I had from being the Minister of Multiculturalism, Official Languages and La Francophonie, the best part about that was that I got to use my French in the House for one and get to share with other people why those things are important. And a lot of these things I'd been learning through the courses here at University of the Fraser Valley. So basically, when you go to model parliament, it's as if Ottawa was postponed and you were actually in Ottawa as the official representatives and members of parliament and ministers. So in effect, for that weekend, I would have had all the responsibilities within the House anyways of being the minister of those portfolios. So basically, the opposition could ask questions when there were bills that related to official languages, the French culture, something to that regards. Then I would have the responsibility or the opportunity to speak and to ask questions and to elaborate on the discussion. So it was really quite a hands-on approach. Then we had smaller workshops as well, which we could get involved with. We had, I believe, just under 100 total members of parliament for the weekend. And I think you have to have a minority government. So the Conservatives being the minority government, we all got ministerial portfolios, which was really cool. And in some years, being the opposition, you won't get that. You'll get to be a critic or something of the sort. So being a minister is a good experience and something that's a little bit more in-depth and more engaging. I think most people in that room have political aspirations of some sort, and personally it's definitely my dream to be a member of parliament, to be in Ottawa representing my constituents, hopefully here in Abbotsford or somewhere in British Columbia, and it's kind of why I became a French major. Part of that appeal is that in the future if I go into politics, work in Ottawa and represent Canadians, I want to represent all Canadians, and I think both official languages are important for doing that. So University Model Parliament began a few decades ago, and it's something that's been going on steadily for all those decades. And it's quite interesting because it brings together university students, and like I've said before, university students with political aspirations. So what it means to them is it gives a lot of them motivation. We've had alumni from the University Model Parliament become senators and politicians in Canada, at a municipal, provincial, and even federal level. So there's a real-life application, and I think that aspect of it makes it really interesting because everyone knows that these are the future leaders of Canada and the future leaders of British Columbia. So it's really interesting to see that as well. And I think the effects is that it makes people comfortable. It gives them the ability to talk in front of a lot of their peers, dress up and be formal for days on end and to really take things seriously. And I think it's a really good part of what they're doing with University Model Parliament. And it's something that you're learning more than just the political realm. You're learning about life and about professionalism and a lot of other aspects of it. Yeah, so for me, it's something that not only is something that's very interesting and engaging, but I've made a lot of friendships and connections with people that have helped with regards to political activities and events that I've gone to. There's more doors that are open when you go to these events and you meet these people. It's the people that are in your domain, the people that you're going to be dealing with probably for a long time to come. So that's really interesting to meet those connections. It also motivates me because often when you're in the Fraser Valley or in Abbotsford, there's not very many people that you meet that are young that want to go into this field. So to be there with a group of just under 100 university students that have the same aspirations, or a lot of them do, it gives you that motivation to make sure you're working really hard and putting in that extra effort and honing your skills, because it's easy to think that you can do it when it's just you alone, but when you see all these others and there's competition, which ultimately is politics, it's good to have those people pushing you and to keep you on your toes. So for a member of parliament, some of the skills that you'll need is you'll need to be a good orator, because you're going to be in the House of Commons, you're going to be giving speeches, you're going to be having questions during question periods on either side of the House. You're going to be either asking those questions or responding to those questions. So that really matters for being a politician, is having that natural skill, the charisma, something with that in mind. But at the same time, there's a lot of aspects of being a member of parliament that aren't as pretty and aren't as shiny. There's a lot of paperwork to be done. You're meeting with a lot of people on a daily basis. And it's really important that you're good with people, you have good communication skills, you're highly organized, or you have a very organized secretary that keeps you accountable. And there's so many aspects to being a member of parliament. And it's very time consuming and it's quite draining, but at the same time, I think it's very rewarding. And that's what I've heard from the members that I have talked to. Being an art student at UFE, one of the best parts of that was getting to learn French and to get to be with all my fellow colleagues and having great professors and teachers that were there the whole time for me. It really gave me the motivation to continue learning French, and I got to go one semester abroad to University of Laval, which was also a great experience. I would highly recommend going into the arts, and of course, I personally think you should go into the French major, or at least get a French minor certificate, because it's a lot of great people inside the program. And something I've enjoyed, and I look forward to my future in politics, hopefully as a member of parliament in the future. And I think a lot of that has to do with my education here at the University of the Fraser Valley.